It started like this, fire crews fighting to douse the flames, but it ended like this. Hours of suffering in stifling temperatures with no air conditioning all day long. Today, a fire on Mount Washington caused so much damage to electrical boxes, people were forced to sweat out the repairs. Channel 4 Action News reporter Keith Jones with when relief is in sight.
Believe it or not, that transformer there used to be green. When the blast happened, it knocked out power to this entire building, giving tenants one big headache.
Take a look at our action cam. Firefighters rushing to the scene. Meanwhile, below, a raging transformer fire knocking out power to the Trimont.
I looked down and saw it, but it was disbelief. I couldn't believe that what you were seeing. I was like, am I really seeing this?
Jean Sega watched in horror from her penthouse above, watching the flames lick the eastern side of the building.
It's just frustrating, and it's a lot of work, a lot of extra steps in a day. Like right now, I'm going to go pack to go to a hotel.
Later in the evening, technicians still haven't figured out why it blew and are still working to restore power.
I'm going to a hotel because I need to sleep tonight.
We caught Chris Bodicher as she was leaving, possibly for good.
Of all the times for the power to go out yesterday, and I still don't know why.
The dryer stopped. The TV went out, and I thought, oh my gosh.
Wally King says the building lost electricity last night at 7 o'clock. Building management told them when power came back on at 2:30 this morning, it must have overloaded the transformer, causing the fire.
120 units, air conditioning, electric, whatever was going on when it all went out, all came to surface and kabush.
Crews are out here now trying to get power back to the entire building. In Mount Washington, Keith Jones, Channel 4 Action News.